إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He's the only one worthy of praise. I seek His help, His guidance, and His forgiveness. I believe in Him and I trust Him. I seek refuge in Almighty Allah from the evil of our passions. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him to Al-Islam, no one can mislead him after Allah. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him astray, no one can guide him after Allah. I testify, O believers, that there is no deity worthy of worship other than Allah Rabbil Alameen. And I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is his messenger and the seal of all the prophets. O Muslims, you must know that the best speech is the speech of Almighty Allah, which is the Quran. The best guidance is the course of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, which is his sunnah. The worst of all affairs is innovation and addition to the religion of Al-Islam. Indeed, every addition to the religion of Al-Islam will lead to hellfire. I adjure you as well as myself to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of your ability. Fear Allah and don't die unless you are in a state of Al-Islam. After this, I greet you all with the greeting of Al-Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. I'd like to welcome you all for continuation of Tafsir, Surah Al-Kahf, Surah number 18. And inshallah, we'll continue with our Tafsir class as every Wednesday. And last thing we'll discuss, that was verse number 80. And in this verse, that Al-Khidr alayhi salam had explained to Musa alayhi salam what he was not able to be patient with. And this was something amazing, and something had troubled Musa to see a righteous man, a knowledgeable man, a man of Allah, that taking a child, innocent soul, and kill it with no just cause as at sea to him. So he told him, وَأَمَّا الْغُلَامُ فَكَانَ أَبَوَاهُ مُؤْمِنَيْنَ فَخَشِينَا أَنْ يُرْهِقَهُمَا طُغْيَانًا وَكُفْرًا فأردنا أن يبدلهما ربهما خيرا منه زكاة وأقرب رحما. And as for the boy, his parents were believers, and we feared lest he should oppress them by religion and disbelief. So the child, if he happened to continue living, He's going to be according the destination of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a kafir, disbeliever. And that the parents are in so much in love with the child. As a result of this, if he remained continuing to be a living out of their love, they will follow the child. Sometimes we may spoil our children so bad to such a degree because he's the only child, or maybe all of them girls and he's the only one boy, or because that we had received this child after a long waiting and you are not expecting that maybe your child can have, your wife can have another children, for whatever reasons, that we may spoil the children and that we're ready to answer their wish regardless. Okay? And as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had told us in the hadith, what the meaning is, الْوَلَدُ مَبْخَلَهْ مَجْبَنَهْ, that the son can be a mean of cowardness and being a miser, because your main thought about how to save for your child, how to have a lot of money for his future. So whenever you want to give fi sabilillah, you think about the child, and this will slow you down of spending in the cause of Allah. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying that the son can be a mabkhala, a cause and a means to make you a miser person, a stingy person. You may buy him sneakers for $300, $400, $500, but when it comes about $50 for the mosque, you think about it twice. You may buy him a toy for $2,000. You may buy him this and that, doesn't matter how much, because he asked for it, you're ready to do it. But when it comes about the cause of Allah, you start to think about everything else. Mabkhala. Also, the child can be a majbana and mahzana. Majbana, to make you jaban, coward. You want to go fi sabilillah, in the cause of Allah, but because the love of the child, you don't want to go. Okay? You stop going for the jihad or going to do something for the cause of Allah because you're scared that you be distant from your child, you may die, and you don't want to be separated from your child. And also the Prophet ﷺ said, mahzana, a mean of sadness for you. Any illness, any sickness, anything bothering him, troubling him, you found yourself always worried about him. So this child been in the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is not known to Musa in that time. If he remain living, he will be a kafir. And that his parents, both of them, were so in love with this child. If he remain living, that he will divert them. They will follow him in kufr due to their much love for him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had intended for the child to be killed and for them to lose a child better than losing their deen. For them to lose their child is better than losing their deen. The possibility that Allah will give them another child and a better child, and even if they did not get another child or a better child, they will remain Muslims, they will die in Islam, they meet Allah as Muslims. فَأَرَدْنَا أَنْ يُبْدِلَهُمَا رَبُّهُمَا خَيْرًا مِّنْهُ زَكَاةً وَأَقْرَبَ رُحْمًا. فَأَرَدْنَا, we intend, from الإرادة. Okay, you say, أَنَا أُرِيدُ وَأَنْتَ تُرِيدُ وَاللَّهُ يَفْعَلُ مَا يُرِيدُ. I want, you want, but Allah, he will manifest what he want. It's not what you want, it's not what I want. Okay? أنت تريد وأنا أريد والله يفعل ما يريد. You want and I want, you wish it, to be this way. I wish it to be this way, but Allah has a will, and the will of Allah will take over your will and my will, and will be whatever Allah. So Allah has irada, and Allah has a will. فَأَرَدْنَا أَنْ يُبْدِلَهُمَا from بَدِيل to exchange, okay, to replace, and هُمَا, okay, يُبَدِّلُ تَبْدِيلًا or أَبْدَلَ, but يُبْدِلَهُمَا, the هُمَا, the pronoun referring to the father and the mother, okay, يُبْدِلُهُمَا رَبُّهُمَا, رَبْ means Lord. Now we add the pronoun, attach a pronoun for those who study in book number 4. Okay? You have attach and detach pronoun. Okay. Okay? You say, Kitabi. Kitab is a book. And the ya comes to be, make it what? My book. But when you look to it in writing, you found the ya attached to the kitab. So this we call attach pronoun. Okay. All right? So there is detach. I say, أنا ذاهب إلى المدينة. I am, I, but is not, ذاهب is a verb by itself. أنا is a pronoun, I. So this أنا is written by itself. This detach pronoun. But inshallah, Brother Saad will tell you more about this, okay? I say, ربهما. So this is attach or detach. You have Rab means Lord. Right. Huma, both. Rabbuhuma, you see the word Rabbuhuma,
right.
They are connected together.
So it's a dual pronoun?
This is a dual and attach pronoun. That means you attach it to the word. The word is Rab. Rab means Lord. Rabbuhuma, both of them, Lord. Rabbuhuma. خيراً خيراً means better. خيراً خير means good. And خيراً also means something better than what is good. Like you have you good, you have excellent, you have, okay? What you call صيغة التفضيل, استاذ? Superlative. Okay, you listen to superlative. Okay. So khayran, that means better. So you have good and better and excellent. So Allah will give them what? Better than the child. It's not going to be only a child, but it's going to be what? Better. How? That they will have a son and he will be a Muslim. Okay? Khayran min hu. Better than him. Zakatan. The zakat. Purification. Righteousness, because the word zakah, okay, min at-taskiyah, to purify something, okay? So the zakah, been named zakah because you take part of your money to give it to the poor and the needy. And this will purify your soul from being having greed, the love of the money. You will have the love of Allah, okay? So when you give this portion of money, this is called zakah, make tazkiyah, purify. It purify your soul and purify your property. Okay? It takes some of this money to give it to the poor and the needy. This make you to learn how to share and care for others. Elevate your iman. خير منهما منه زكاة وأقرب من القرب. You say المسجد قريب. The mosque is near. والمعمل بعيد and the factory is a distant قريب and بعيد okay so أقرب okay again صيغة صبح expression okay تفضيل أقرب قريب and أقرب there is near and nearer and the nearest أقرب okay that more nearer or nearer رحمة mercy. So he explained to him about the child. And as for the boy,
His parents were believers, and we fear lest he should oppress them by religion and disbelieve. So what happened? So we intend that their Lord should change him for them, for one better in righteousness and near to mercy. So whenever you lose in something, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will replace you with something better. If you be patient and you thank Allah for the lost, okay? Regardless how much this thing is dear to you, you like it, you love it, but you have to understand the whole life is about test. And you have to stand firm and to hold your deen whenever the trial or the calamity fall in you. And to understand, even if you did not see it in material, you will see it with Allah in Yawm al-Qiyamah in reward and the blessings. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will test you. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove some of your sins, or He will elevate you in Jannah ranks, or that Allah will give you something better. But when you have faith and you have patience, all right? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intend for the child to be killed by the Khidr, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the plan is to give the parents, okay, a better child, a Muslim child, and he will care more for their, for his parents, okay? وَأَقْرَحْبَ رُحْمَا. Okay, third explanation. Why Al-Khidr renovated the wall or erected the building that was about to fall in the city, although that the people of the city refused to entertain or to show hospitality to Al-Khidr and Musa alayhim as-salam. And when the Khidr saw the wall about falling, he went and fixed it. And Musa alayhi salam suggest for the Khidr to receive a payment, money for it. As a result of this, the Khidr told him, this is it. Now this is the third strike and you was not supposed to discuss anything or to ask me about anything, this is it. So they decide, everybody go about his way, but now the Khidr given him the explanation, why did he do the wall? Why did he build it? Okay? He said, وَأَمَّا الْجِدَارُ فَكَانَ لِغُلَامَيْنِ يَتِيمَيْنِ فِي الْمَدِينَةِ وَكَانَ تَحْتَهُ كَنْزٌ لَهُمَا وَكَانَ أَبُوهُمَا صَالِحًا فَأَرَادَ رَبُّ ربك أن يبلغا أشدهما ويستخرجا كنزهما رحمة من ربك وما فعلته عن أمري ذلك تأويل ما لم تسطع عليه صبرا. This is a new verse, is it? وَأَمَّا الْجِدَارِ فَكَانَ لِغُلَامَيْنِ يَتِيمَيْنِ فِي الْمَدِينَةِ وَكَانَ تَحْتَهُ كَنْزٌ لَهُمَا وَكَانَ أَبُوهُمَا صَالِحًا فَأَرَادَ رَبُّ ربك أن يبلغا أشدهما
ويستخرجا كنزهما رحمة من ربك وما فعلته عن أمري ذلك تأويل ما لم تستع عليه صبرا
وأما الجدار as for
الجدار the wall now he's going to give him the explanation وأما الجدار as for that means the explanation you want to know what's happening about this wall فكان it was لغلامين غلامين is مثنى of غلام okay a boy who didn't reach the age of puberty you call him غلام غلامين two boys لغلامين for the two boys the lamb here okay لغلامين for غلامين يتيمين alright what is their case they are orphaned يتيم now يتيمين alright like كتاب كتابان يتيم يتيمان Alright, Muslim, Musliman, two Muslims, two books, two orphans. This is came with Ya and Noon, not Alif and Noon, because this is the grammar here, cause this is change. Because the lamb, it makes jar. But understand it as is for now. Okay. But Yatimaini is Musanna, is a dual of Yatim. Okay? Okay. Yatim. فأما اليتيم فلا تقهر so يتيم is a single يتيمين is dual في المدينة في means in المدينة the city the town that they went to it not المدينة of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم but he's talking about the place that they went and the people they don't want feed them or give them hospitality في المدينة you say مدينة كولومبيا the city of Colombia okay مدينة وكان it was تحته the word تحت means under or beneath okay تحته with the pronoun okay تحته under it Okay, تحته under it كنز كنز or كنز is still the same كتاب and كتاب is the same one have a double vowel and one with no vowel كنز كنز means a treasure a big hole full with gold and silver and all kind of expensive stuff كنز a treasure كنز لهما for them هما means both لهما for both of them وكان and it was أبوهما Ab means father. Abu hu means his father. Abu huma, they're both fathers. Okay? Ab, alif and ba means ab, means father. When you say abi, means my father. Right. Ab means father. Now you have ab plus the pronoun huma, abu huma. Means both of them what? Father. كان أبوهما صالحاً. صالح. صالح means a righteous. A person who does the good and stay away from the evil. And the feminine of it is say what? صالحة. صالح and صالحة. مؤمن and مؤمنة. مسلم and مسلمة. Okay? وكان أبوهما صالحا. فأراد. Again the word أراد. Wish. Want. Intend. فأراد ربك your Lord intend. أن يبلغ. أن من ذات يبلغ. To reach. To attain. To achieve. أشدهما. From شديد, شدة, strength, power, mighty. For them to reach their strength. Because they are young boys. So Allah wants them to reach, grow up, be strong. And to do, for what? To do what? وَيَسْتَخْرِجَ. To take out. كَنْزَهُمَا. كَنْز means a treasure, and كَنْزَهُمَا, both treasures. رَحْمَةً, a mercy. مِنْ رَبِّكَ, from your Lord. وَمَا فَعَلْتُهُ. مَا not. وَمَا and not. فَعَلْتُهُ from the verb فَعَالَ. To do. To act. فَعَلْتُ I did. فَعَلْتُهُ I did it. You see this one word here فَعَلْتُهُ but three things in it. The verb and the subject and مفعول به. What he says, Subhi? The object. So three things in one word. فعلته. فعل means did. فعلت I did. فعلته I did it. وما فعلته عن أمري, from my accord, that I was not doing this thing smooth, okay, out of fun, that something that I felt to do and I did it. He said, Musa, listen, all what you saw, okay, breaking the ship, fixing the wall, killing the child, وَمَا فَعَلْتُهُ I didn't do this عَنْ أَمْرِي from my own. Okay, it's only something صَنَّفْلُ كده على مزاجي. I felt to do it, so I did it. No. He say, listen, I didn't do any of these things عَنْ أَمْرِي. I'm only been directed. Somebody is directing me. Allah is giving me direction, giving me a direction, what to do, what not to do. I'm not doing things, making mischief in the earth, killing and breaking and building and وَمَا فَعَلْتُهُ عَنْ أَمْرِي ذَلِكَ تَأْوِيلُ مَا لَمْ تَسْتِعْ عَلَيْهِ صَبْرًا. ذَلِكَ, that اسم إشارة. ذلك, that, that means the things that I did. تأويل, تفسير, interpretation, explanation. ما لم, what you was not. تستع يستطع you could not عليه صبرا have patience with it. This Musa, the explanation of things that you could not understand, you could not go on with it and live with it, and he was so mad. And so he's saying, and as for the wall, it belongs to two orphan boys in the town, and there was under it a treasure belonging to them, and their father was a righteous man, and your Lord intend that they should attain their age of full strength and take out their treasure as a mercy from your Lord. And I did them not of my own accord. That is interpretation of those things over which you could not hold patience. Again?
Yes.
Word to word or the fall?
No, we got word to word. But,
again. Now we got it word by word, and this is the English translation. So now, he say, listen, Musa. In actuality, if you can imagine somebody that you're asking them for hospitality, okay, can I buy food? Can I do this? He said, no, 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 no. And after this, you see his car has a flat tire. You go get the jack and do it and put it, okay, and keep walking. Strange. People been bad to you, okay? They are not showing hospitality. They are not giving you anything. And after this, you're fixing the wall for free. And at least we can tell them we fix a wall in your town, can have some money or give us some food for what we did. Okay? Musa, he felt it strange. But Musa, he's not acquainted with what the Khidr acquainted with. All right? As for the Khidr, he's getting direction from Allah to do the things that he's doing. The story here, that there is a wall in town, and this wall is about to fall apart. So let it fall apart. He said, no. But this wall belonged to two children. So what? Say, وَكَانَ أَبُوهُمَا صَالِحًا. He said, under the wall, there is a treasure. So what does this mean if the wall fall apart? The people of town is going to see what? They're going to discover what? The treasure. And the treasures belong to what? To two orphan boys, little kids. So what are you expecting from a town that it did not even give hospitality to the guest? Can you imagine if these people get to see the gold? So what's he going to do? Is he going to take it? Yeah. And these kids are little kids. They could not defend themselves. They could not, you understand, fight for their property, nothing. So if we leave this wall fall, we did not make some renovation to stay for a while, that the treasure will be exposed to the people of town. The people of town going to take it. But there is something missing here. What? He said, وَكَانَ أَبُوهُمَا صَالِحًا. Their father, okay, which already died, he used to be a righteous man. So what does this mean? What's the relationship here? Because your righteousness will remain as insurance and security for your children after you. Not the life insurance. You make insurance with Allah through your good deed while you are alive. So Allah said, وَكَانَ أَبُوهُمَا صَالِحًا, and their father used to be a righteous. As a result of this, what he did good in his life, now we're going to protect him in his absence,
And we're going to take care of these two children until they grow. All right? So your good deed in your life is not only helping you, it's helping you and your family after you. Okay? وَكَانَ أَبُوهُمَا صَالِحًا فَأَرَادَ رَبُّكَ أَنْ يَبْلُغَ أَشُدَّهُمَا. So your Lord Musa, he wants this to continue and hidden like this until they reach their strength, not their maturity. Because you can be rich at the age of puberty, but you are not having strength. So Allah wants them to come to be strong so they can defend their property. If somebody wants to understand to come, they have a strength. يَبْلُغَ أَشُدَّهُمَا, the full strength of both of them. And it seemed that subhanAllah, that the Khidr had rebuilt the wall in a way to fit into certain age. Because as example, if you make it concrete, talking about the way how we build things. And now these are children, they grow up, they became mature, full strength, they get married, they have a children, but this because a wall made out of concrete maybe couldn't stay until even grandchildren come. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can give the wisdom for the way how this wall to be built to measure according certain age for these children so they can get their money in the right time. Not at any time, not while they too young, not while they too old, they could not benefit from it. So here the Khidr will build the wall in a manner and a way to fit a certain age. So when the certain age elapses, the wall will what? Will fall again. And who's going to see it? The two boys, but they already in a way and in the strength they can protect their property. You see? And it seemed also, Blugha and both of them, so that means both of them, they were twin. Because if someone of them, one is 6 years old and one 8 years old, okay? So one will reach a full strength before the other. Okay? So it seems that he's going to build it in a time that fits with when both of them reach age of strength in the same time. So both of them can help each other and protect one another and be backing each other to take their property. وَيَبْلُغَ أَشُدَّهُمَا. And when they reach, وَيَسْتَخْرِجَ كَنْزَهُمَا رَحْمَةً مِنْ رَبِّكَ. And they will be able to take out, استخرجَ, to take out from خَرَجَ. خَرَجَ, the verb originally, خَرَجَ, and istakhraja, kharaja to go out. Okay? Yastakhrija kanzahuma, and they will take out their treasure. And this is rahmah from your Lord, mercy. Proper insurance. How that they can save things and protect things for you or and after you, and even if there is no safe deposit box, even if there is no bank, even if there is no security and cameras and all these things, Allah will take care of things. But only if you have a trust in Allah. And you're doing the right thing, Allah will make things to work for you and for those who are after you. وَيَسْتَخْرِجَ كَنْزَهُمَا رَحْمَةً مِنْ رَبِّكَ. That what you see this is a mercy from Allah. How he make things work. Okay? وَمَا فَعَلْتُهُ عَنْ أَمْرِي. وَمَا فَعَلْتُهُ عَنْ أَمْرِي. موسى, you're going to have to leave and I'm going to have to go also. But we're living in a good term. Now listen, I explained to you, Musa, why I did everything. But listen, Musa, all what you saw or what I told you about, I did not make it in my own. وَمَا فَعَلْتُهُ عَنْ أَمْرِي. I was not doing haphazard things from me. the way I felt about it. No, I did everything, okay? Not from my own affairs, not my own assumption and conclusion. There an amri, so that means there is another amr, there is another command, there is another one given direction, given order, and this Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ذلك تأويل ما لم تستع عليه صبرا. Now Musa, this is the explanation and the tafsir, the breakdown of all what you was not able to be patient with. ذلك تأويل ما لم تستع عليه صبرا. Now you find Musa, now you understood why. Okay, now you can go your way, I'm going to go my way. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he made dua and say, may Allah send mercy on my brother Musa. We wish that he was more patient so we can learn more about the things that is hidden. But here now, we want to say something. Very important, pay attention here. In the end, it's saying what? وَمَا فَعَلْتُهُ عَنْ أَمْرِي. Remember this. Mahmoud, وَمَا فَعَلْتُهُ عَنْ أَمْرِي. I didn't do this what? In my own what? A care. Yeah. I did not do it in my own. Because this is the whole problem with some people thinking and believing that certain people have some kind of a special relationship with Allah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala come to them in their dream, or that Allah will reveal them, or Allah will inspire them to do certain things. And some of the deviant people of the Sufism, because even Sufism, you found people, they're going too far to the right, too far to the left, okay? Watch spooky stuff. You found somebody, as example, doesn't pray. And he's the head of the tariqah, as example. But he said, don't ask. Al-murid, if you want to be murid, mean you want to be a seeker, okay? Don't ask your sheikh any question. لا تعترض فتنطرد. Don't show any objection or you'll be kicked out. So he said, كن بين يد المرشد كالميت بين يد المغسل. Be with your sheikh like the dead body in the hand of the washer. When you are dead and the people watching you, if they put you on the left side, you're not going, hey, wait, watch, because this side hurt me. No. They put you left, they change your right, they put soap in your face, whatever. Can you do anything? Can you say, oh, no, don't do this? Or give me warmer water or any? Can you? You did. So, in the philosophy of those Sufis, that you have to be with your sheikh, because the sheikh is supposed to be what? It means to take you to Allah. You could not go to Allah in your own. So you have to have what? You have to have somebody to lead you to Allah. Okay? So from the way that you have to be with your sheikh, like a dead person, he tell you sit in this corner, you sit in this corner. Okay, go and keep walking in the desert for 3 hours. You keep walking. Where you go? He said, keep walking. You are not supposed to ask where or why or what. No, do it. Do it. And they said, this is the only way you can reach, that you be with your sheikh like what? Like a dead body. Tell you right, you do it right. You tell you left, you do it left. This is one. The second thing, that no i'tirad, no objection. Alaykum as-salam. What does this mean, no objection? Whatever that you see your sheikh is doing, never ever tell him, what are you doing? In the book that you study, say haram. but the sheikh has a different sharia. And you right away tell you, look, listen, Musa was gone by the book. Khidr has a ilm ladunni. The situation of Khidr and Musa never repeated again, with exception. Same thing like Maryam and Jesus was a unique situation, Allah to show his ability and his ayat. No woman come today and said that the Holy Ghost, okay, had breathed into me and God gave me a child. She is not have a boyfriend, she's not dating, she's not married, she's not, and she have a child. How? The Holy Ghost. No, this was a unique and a special way Allah make it for one single woman. The same thing, the story of Musa and Khidr was a unique and one single incident, never happened, never will happen. سَوَاقِيمُ الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُ الزَّكَاةَ وَارْكَعُوا مَعْرُ. So this is a book tell you pray. But when you see your sheikh doesn't pray, never ask him. The sheikh doesn't have to pray. The sheikh has a different relationship with God. You pray because you start, you're only a beginner. Okay? And they have their own tafsir. وَعَبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. And worship your Lord until certainty come to you. There is a verse in Quran say, worship Allah until yaqeen come to you. Say, so when the person reach the yaqeen, he doesn't تسقط عليه عنه التكاليف. When you reach to the level of yaqeen, certainty, you are not mukallaf anymore. So you can go out of the law. No Quran, no sunnah, you don't have to go by this. So you, as a murid, you have to pray 5 times a day, at least. But me, as a sheikh, I don't have to pray. I have a special communication with God, and I already had reach. I can even look in the protect tablet, and I can tell you what is written for you. So I already had reach the state of yaqeen. You are not available for this. So if you see your sheikh doesn't pray, don't object. Otherwise, you're going to be kicked out. You don't know how to reach. You want to reach to God. You want to understand, to see how they understand you can walk in the water, that you can eat the fire, that you understand somebody will shoot you with gun and you don't die. You have to continue behind the sheikh. To such a degree that they tell you, and some of these people used to have sex with animals, with the cows and donkeys, and the murid, the student is not supposed, if he see the sheikh doing something, he keep going about what he's doing, because the sheikh has his own tafsir and he has his own explanation, and he is like the Khidr. And some people still believe that the Khidr living until today. So whatever action you see the sheikh is doing, this what you see, but he has different interpretation and he see it in a different way. I'm coming. I'm not telling you stories. And I'm telling you things that some of it, I lived it, I saw it with my eyes, in the villages, because the more you go away from the city, less knowledge, okay? The people more taqwa, more clear heart, they can believe almost anything. Same way like we see people go around the grave and kissing and crying and begging. I'm telling you things not only from the books. I saw things in books, I read about people, and I saw certain things. Even be surprised, I tell you that I used to have some of my relatives, you understand, they bought these knives and things, from here to here to bring it, walk on the fire, all this stuff. But they try to reach. They are in tariqa. Okay? They want to reach. And I observe people as a child, they making celebration. Maghrib comes, Isha comes, no prayer. And when everything is over, maybe even they taken drugs. But what you see, you as a murid, you could not object. You have to understand the Sheikh has a different explanation. Because Khidr, Musa went to buy the Torah. But the Khidr what? Has ladunni ilm, a direct knowledge from Allah. So the people, some of the people still believe that this al-ilm al-ladunni still exists. And you, Musa, can see it in some way. But the Khidr, he has his own explanation. As a result of this, the Khidr was able to kill. The Khidr was able to break the ship, okay? But in the law of Musa is wrong, is it? They tell you this. So they still believe, some people still believe that this law still exists. And there is people who have this direct in touch with God. And there is people who are Muslim and much better than me and you. They don't have to pray. Why? Because they already had reach. And they have the ability to see what is written in the protected tablet. And some even, they know, like the, some of the Shia, they believe that the Imam is better than the Prophet and the Messenger. And that the Imam, he knows where he's going to die and when he's going to die. We don't believe in this stuff. Khidr and Musa was a true personality. And with a true story, but with unique as much Maryam and Jesus been having given birth, his mother given birth to him with no father, never repeated. Musa and Khidr never repeated. And the Quran saying, ذلك تأويل ما لم تستطع عليه صبرا. Me and you could not be patient with things like this. And Musa was not. But he said to him, in the end, وَمَا فَعَلْتُهُ عَنْ أَمْرِي. I didn't do this from my own. So you said the Sheikh, no. We have things with God. And God shows us the way. He tells us what to do. A Muslim doesn't matter. He's a ABC Muslim. Or a PhD degree Muslim in Islam. Let's imagine. All of us have to go by the book of Allah and the Sunnah of Rasulullah. Me and you, I make Hajj 20 times or 100 times. I'm born in Arabia or I'm born in Israel. Still, I have to pray 5-time prayers if I'm a Muslim. Not you understand, say, oh, brother, I'm from Arabia, you from America. I'm Arab, you are, you understand, what? Okay? You pray 5 times, this doesn't apply to you. Everybody, even the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, Umar, Uthman, Ali, all of them have to do it. Okay? Everybody, including the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is guided by the Quran and the teaching of the Sunnah that Allah had revealed it also. There is no exception. There is nothing out of the law or under the counter that for you and not for the other person. Everybody about the obligation are the same. Yes, Sister Anna. This is very, he said the question and he said the answer. I don't know what these people, how they can justify this. Okay? These people, they understand, say, Rabbina Rabbi Lub. And this is a very famous saying in Egypt. He said, brother, why don't you pray, brother? He said, yeah, me. خلي على الله ربنا رب قلوب. Don't, it's not a big thing, the salah. Allah doesn't care about you going up and down. ربنا looks to your hearts. Allah looks to your heart. If your heart is good, you don't cheat, you don't lie, you don't, you understand? You can be better in the sight of Allah than a person who in the mosque doing this and that. Subhanallah. Even the Prophet have to pray. And if anybody thinks that he's better than the Prophet, this will be kufr. What the Prophet ﷺ said about the people who came. جاء رهط إلى بيوت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يسألون عن عبادته، فلما أخبروا بها كأنهم تقالوها وقالوا أين نحن من رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، وقد غفر الله له ما تقدم من ذنب وما تأخر. Few people came to the houses of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Questioning Aisha رضي الله عنها about how the Prophet used to worship Allah. How? Because they see the Prophet outside, but they don't see the Prophet inside the house. They want to know about the extra prayer, the sunnah, the fa. So Aisha told them, he sleep part of the night and make tahajjud part of the night. He fast some days, and breakfast, sleep with his wife. Okay? So they said, أين نحن من رسول الله? Oh, the Prophet has been forgiven already, but me and you, we don't know where we're going. So one of them, he said, what? I pray the night, not non-stop. No sleep, tahajjud, every night, from Isha until Fajr. The second one say, أصوم الظهر, say, I'm going to fast every day. The third one, he said, what? I'm going to separate myself from my wife. They have good intention. Everybody want to be more devoted to Allah. So one going to be more devoted by no sleep. One will fast every day. And one will stay away from his wife. No relation, intimate relation. You think the Prophet was happy with this? He came to the Prophet and said, Wallahi inni la'alamukum billah wa atqakum lillah. By Allah, I know about Allah better than any one of you. And I fear Allah more than any one of you, but I still take part of the sleep at night. I still break my fast some days. And I spend time with my wife. I sleep with my wife. فَمَنْ رَغِبَ عَنْ سُنَّتِي فَلَيْسَ مِنِّي. Whosoever object to my sunnah, he is not part of my ummah. We have to do it according to the way of the Prophet ﷺ. There is no way that we can say, oh, because he's the Prophet, but I have to do more, I have to be this and that. You have to do it according to the way of the Prophet ﷺ. We're going to stop here today because, inshallah, we're going to start a new segment with Surah Al-Kahf about Dhul-Qarnayn, the two horns man. Okay? And this, with this, we came to the end to see the journey of Musa and Khidr. They have to depart. Everybody have to go his way. With no doubt that Musa alayhi salam had got to know that somebody there is more knowledgeable than him. And also we got to know that this man was not making it in his own, but he'd been directed by Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send peace and blessing on the Prophet Musa and on our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah shower us and all the Muslims with his mercy. And inshallah we'll continue next week. It seems that next week is going to be time change, is it? We need to change it to see what time we're going to start the class. So it's going back or forth?
It's going forward.
It's going to go reverse or going to second gear? So that means now will be 9 o'clock,
yeah.
Is it? So that means Maghrib will be like 7:30. I think this will be too late for people to come. So we say that the class will start at 6 o'clock, reasonable?
I think so. What time is?
What about we say 6:15? More reasonable. 6:15, reasonable. So by the time we finish class, we make Maghrib. Everybody go eat dinner, you understand, and go sleep after this, after they do the homework. You need to get another phone, brother. It's taking too long. Yes, turn it the other way.
So it's this
Sunday coming? Yeah, so I think 6:15 will be. Anybody have objection? At least those who come, okay?
That's good. I think that'll work.
6:15?
Yes, so it looks like Asr will be
at 5:15. So by the people close their shops and go home and change and come back,
yeah.
6:15 I think it makes sense, okay. Inshallah. Thank you for being here. Please inform the others who did not show up tonight that the class will be changing to 6:15, inshallah, every Wednesday with exception of the first Wednesday of the month. Subhanak Allahumma bihamdik, nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. For those who join us on the internet, Sorry, we could not entertain any class, any question for tonight because it's time for the adhan and the salah. Subhanak Allahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen.